chicken galantine. We use one chicken. We have over mise en place that is done here. We want to start off, sometimes we end up cutting the wing off first and utilizing that. You cut it right through the joint, and sometimes we break the knuckles out and make it seem like a little lollipop. We're not going to do that for today because we're more concerned with getting this done. First step is to cut through the skin all the way to the backbone on the back of the chicken. So the breast is up here. We're flipping it over and cutting the skin off on the back. Because the very first step we want to do is remove all of this skin from the chicken in one piece. So I'm going to just take it off. It's very similar to just removing your shirt inside out, right off your body. Pull it down off the legs. Keep on this other drum wing flat off of that side. Pull this off. There. Now we have the entire bird skin. You can see this skin, we're going to roll it up and save it because when we start rolling out our galantine, this is going to be the outside of the galantine. In the next process, you want to try and as cleanly as possible take off the breast and the tenderloin. If you wanted, you could pull out the wishbones. Some people do, some don't. It's just a V-shaped bone right inside, technically the collarbone. You pull that out, then you can get a little deeper to get your meat out. And then you take this breast meat right off the flat side of the knife, just kind of shaving that right off, all the way down and around the wing. Take that, and then we'll take the tenderloin out. Do the same thing with the other side. Now we have two breasts, boneless, skinless, all the skin, two tenderloins. All we need is the leg and thigh. I like to flip them upside down, kind of break it so the bones come out of the joint. And then we start at the butt, right against that bone, and we cut right up to where it cuts through the joints, and then you cut down through with the tip of the knife. That removes the oyster right here. So then once you cut the oyster off of the bone, then you can just pull it this way, and you see that whole piece of oyster meat comes off, and you have this bare bone here that looks kind of like a oyster shell. That's our leg and thigh still connected against that bone. Cut right to where you're separating thigh bone from the body, cut down into that cavity with the tip of the knife, pull it away from it, and it pulls that oyster meat so you don't lose any meat right off of that shell. Now we have those two. We have our carcass, which we'll save for stalks. The last thing you want to do with the meat, you're going to cut the leg and thigh apart, usually a rung of fat coming right down through here, which is generally right where you cut through. That little line of fat, cut right there, and cut the two apart. Now we're gonna remove all the meat off the thigh. You wanna cut back behind the bone, just up top, and then the sharp part of the knife, but facing down, not like this, but the knife shape facing up, the scraping down. You're gonna take, cleanly get all that meat off of there. Bones we'll save for stock, and this is all our leg and thigh meat. Wishbone. I think if I need any more meat to make my weight, I'll cut some of the leg drumstick meat off, and with that then I can pull some of that sinew out of it, some of the tendons, but it should be good. Now we'll go to stage two. So now we're going to go to step two, which is to first take our white wine and shallots, 2 ounces of each. We're gonna reduce the white wine off sec which means almost dry. So it just lightly cooks the shallots, brings out all those flavors and aromas. We cook most of the wine away, but we retain all the flavors from the wine. So that's cooked au sec. Lightly cook the shallots. While those are cooling, we're gonna make our mousseline style forcemeat, which is lighter, whiter colored meats that are pureed mixed with heavy cream and egg yolks. So putting all that 8 ounces of dark meat in the food processor. Along with one egg. Like a mashed potato consistency. That's just about what we are. It's pretty good. Now we're just gonna fold in the garnish. So this stuff we saved, our pistachios, are gonna go in. We don't wanna process that. Our parsley, and our brunoise of smoked ham. My shallots.
Oh yeah.
And white wine. Almost a tragedy. Now we're good. Voila. Next stage. Pound out the chicken breasts. Plastic wrap on the bottom and on the top. This keeps them from splashing chicken juice everywhere. We use the side, the soft side, smooth side of the meat mallet because we don't want to get it all, you know, broken up. The chicken's really tender. Take the skin and do our best that job of trying to form it into a rectangle. And these are small. I'm gonna take our chicken breasts. I'm gonna grab me a little salt, pepper, and season this chicken breast. I'm gonna now pipe some of the force meat into the middle. This is the biggest piping bag we have here, so that's what I'm stuck with. And now I'm gonna take these. Do you have any extra parsley by chance? We have a little extra parsley. Clean that up. And I'm going to pack these in partially. These two little tenderloins, you see how small the bird is. I'm going to lay those skinny sides in the middle. Then I'm going to lay it there. Pop it. pinch it on the sides, pull it together. Now I'll grab a little foil. Sometimes you take and tie off the plastic wrap. Get these nice and tight. See, this is a nice, perfect cylinder. And then it's ready. Okay, last step, putting our finished galantines into the simmering water. The two that the men here did. Okay, group B, team one, team two. This is down over it, so it holds them under the water, nice and tight. And then you can see he's got his red onion pea going to serve with it. Boil for about probably 30, 35, 40 minutes until it gets to 10. What temperature?
165.
165, correct. All right. Slicing of pâtés, terrines, and galantines. For any of those above, you want to use a nice, long, very sharp slicing knife. This is a duck pâté made by you guys. So you're going to be slicing this down for your platters. I also put a sheet tray and number my slices the whole way down. We'll want 9 slices out of this. One is going to be for the plate. 8 of them are going to be for the platter. We won't use this clear end. We'll start our slices in a little bit. We want them 1/4 inch apart. So we'll start slicing on the end, knowing we're not going to use this piece, but we're going to have to cut into it and see how our duck pate looks. Looks pretty nice, actually. I'm impressed. We want our slices to be about 1/4 inch. And when you take your slices, your knife, you want to use that entire blade and do a nice smooth 1/4 inch slice from top to bottom, keeping it nice and uniform. And then maybe we're going to start using some pieces from right here. So maybe these 3 can be test ones, and then this will be my first good slice of duck pate, which will go right there. And then my next slice will be 2, 3, 4, all the way down to 9. And then we'll begin to aspic these. And we'll definitely save the end, because we might want to use this as a solid piece on our platter when we plate everything up. And then we can start cutting our duck pates, our seafood terrines, our chicken galantines, and our liver and pork pates. All right. So. Seafood terrine. Nice little short, but that's all you got. How's your duck pate coming out?
It's good.
It's pretty
good.
Yeah, your ham's falling off the edge a little bit. Sergey, seafood terrine, looks nice. Jordan doing his